What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Third Person. This is the Third Person Podcast. I am one of three hosts for this show. My name is Chris, and with me, as always, are my friends, Jesse.
How's it going?
Damn it, that way. And Mike, that way.
What's up, guys?
We got another special episode for you today. This is going to be our second Walking Dead Q&A on this channel. Jess?
That's right.
So this Q&A is going to encompass the show, part B of season 7, the comics, and the games.
Yes.
Yeah, we got a little bit of everything these questions this time, right, boys?
Yeah, we got a lot of questions from you guys, a lot of questions, which was awesome. And although we won't get a chance to answer all of them on this video, we will most likely be able to answer them at least in the comment for you.
Yes.
So bear with us if we don't get to your question yet, but we will. So right off the bat, thank you everyone for who sent in questions and who participated in this. We love it. And so why don't we just go right into these questions? And again, this is for season 7. You know, well, anything really, but we just finished season 7, part A, or first half of season 7. And a lot of stuff's gone down. So let's just get right to the first question. And this is actually an interesting question. We talked about whether we should make this the first question or not. This first question comes from viewer Dean Washington and I'm horrible names. Danae Washington or whatever. Taking into account that Rick, Andy, had a contract for 6 years with 1 year option, what can the show do to keep it moving if Rick decides to walk away? So that's if, you know, Andy Lincoln decides to not continue his contract and, you know, move on to something else. If Rick was resigned, then after the contract expires, that's the second part of the question. What, you know, what would happen if Rick were resigned, you know, after his contract expires? So question, what would happen? What would the show do? What do you guys think the show would do, or how could they move the show forward, knowing that right now in the comic, Rick is still there, you know, if they're following the comic? So what do you guys think?
Well, that's a simple one for me.
Yeah.
Andrew Lincoln's not going anywhere. And if he did, they'd have to shift the main role to Carl.
That's right. Yeah. That's what I would probably assume myself.
Carl? Okay.
Yeah. Give it to Carl.
You got to keep it to a Grimes last name, you know?
Or Michonne.
Maybe even Maggie. I mean, who, you know? There's
we
a lot
give her
of,
too much credit.
You know, there's a lot of, but she has, you know, they're giving her a bigger role now,
know?
Without getting too crazy into the question, I mean, Rick isn't going anywhere.
I don't know if I think it would end up, I don't think they would send it to one person. I mean, I don't think they would give it just to Carl. I don't think that character's strong enough.
Season.
What?
Canceled within a season.
Yeah. God. No, but I think it would be like a council. They'd make it so you'd have Michonne step
Daryl.
Up. Carol.
Daryl,
Carol. Daryl, Carol, Maggie.
Morgan?
They'd have to make Morgan. But Lincoln's not going anywhere.
He's not going anywhere. Question's finished.
Yeah, he's not going
that
anywhere.
That was short, sweet, and to the point. We're all in agreement. He's not going anywhere.
All right, moving on. Number two.
Oh, that's me, right?
That's you, man.
Do you think this is a great question, actually, because I have this, I've been thinking this myself. Do you think we'll ever get Negan's backstory in the show? I do believe we never have a true confirmation in the comics about Negan's backstory, just some rumors. I heard he was a gym teacher or a used car salesman. Any truth to that, guys? And that's from one of our loyal viewers of the channel, Kid Slap.
Kid Slap 13, I believe, right?
13, yeah. Yes. Yeah. If you guys want to go start it first, Chris.
Well, I mean, you know, Jesse and I actually spoke about this in our last comic review of the last comic that, you know, we didn't get a backstory, but...
Yeah.
We got a little bit of something where,
views.
Yeah, we got something where it was like he is human, and there could be reasons for specifically his love for Lucille, okay?
Yeah.
And, you know, and I don't know, we talked about this on camera or not, Jesse. I think it was maybe off camera. I don't think we did during the episode, but, you know, Lucille might have been his name of his wife, daughter, mom, who knows? You know what I mean? But there is a reason for that. But I was excited at the prospect of maybe possibly getting anything backstory in the comics. So will we get it in the show? Oh, my God. I mean, I don't know. I definitely want a backstory. I'd love to find out more about this character because we did get a little backstory with the governor. You know, and I read the novels, you know, chronicling the rise of the governor. In fact, that was the name of one of the books was The Rise of the Governor. And so that information is out there, how he became, why he became, things like that. Yeah. Negan, you know, is a very interesting character because he doesn't have any of that right now. So, I mean, I don't know if they're going to show it. I don't think I can answer that. I'd love to see it though. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Yes, he was hinted at. I don't know if they outright said it, but both the used car salesman and the teacher, I don't know if he was a gym coach, was hinted at heavily in the comics.
Right.
Now, will we get a backstory on him? Hopefully.
Yeah.
I mean, the guy in the comics, if you're not caught up with him, it's an amazing character, and the arc is just, his character arc is perfect.
Yeah.
And to get more depth of him, it'd help you understand where he's at, where he's come from.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, I know from glimpses of just, you know, little rumor things myself, probably just like Kid Slap even heard the rumors. Yeah. I thought there might have even been a rumor that maybe Kirkman or may have kind of hinted at some things, possibly like the gym teacher vibe, I thought.
I believe it was mentioned in a comic he used to be a gym teacher.
Yeah.
Or used car salesman.
Yeah, see, I mean, I don't remember that, but I think, you know, obviously everybody knows you guys are a little bit ahead of me in the comic. But I definitely think, as going to the part of the question about, you know, like a backstory of him, I think that would be awesome. Something, you know, we tend to see that with major characters. Sometimes not even with major characters. We saw the Enid backstory.
Yeah, we get plenty of secondary character backstories. Why wouldn't get one for a major character like Negan?
Yeah, maybe there'll be some major, pivotal, vital part of the story. Something that Negan goes through. Some kind of maybe with the possible war. Or something like that, and then we'll see a glimpse. You know, they want to show us a little bit of that humanity. And like you said, with the whole bat thing, I kind of heard that too, with maybe his wife was named Lucille or something
that. That's kind of, so I don't know. But I think we're all in agreement that we would love to see one.
Oh, of course. Yeah, it would be great.
Absolutely. And the show might be...
think that's good with it. Yeah. They're always pretty good with, you know, with these backstories.
Yeah. All right. We'll move on to the next one.
Yep. Let's go to question 3.
Do it.
And this one's a game question, and it's going to have spoilers in it. So when I wave my hand like that again, spoilers are over.
Yeah, this is one of my favorites because I'm a big Telltale guy.
I'm wondering, in the game, do you think we could ever see the Lee or Clementine character ever appear on the show? That would be so awesome, even if for a short time, and that's from Michelle Cox. So do we want to address the elephant in the room with Lee appearing in the show?
Well, Lee's not... Well, that's not to say he can't, though.
Could, yeah, just because of, you know, like you said, spoiler, if you haven't played the game, Lee dies.
Season one of the game.
He did meet Glenn, but...
Glenn was still alive at the time, because that goes way back.
Spoiler!
Yeah. But
Glenn's not around anymore either.
Being a big fan of the game... and recently downloading, you know, the newest season 3, I was always, because first off, if you haven't played it, play it. It's an awesome game. The dynamic between the characters, even though it's a video game, and just how they put everything together with Lee and meeting Clementine and them going through all the trials and learning this new world was just awesome. If you do, you know, without getting too much into the game, if you do play, you know what they go through and you know what kind of characters they turn into and what your decisions and your choices you can make for them. But that would be sweet because we just know how strong those two characters are, and I would love that.
I would love that. So here's a cool thing. I don't think they would bring the Lee character in. I think if they were to bring any character in, it would be Clementine, especially now that... Now, again, I haven't finished season 2 or 3 yet. I have season 2. I have to play it still. Haven't started season 3 yet. But, again, what's cool about these things is that, guys, if you want to play this game, it's not solely for a console or the computer. They have them now on mobile, on your tablet, on your iPhone, Android, on your phone, on a tablet. They have them now, and they're cheap. So even if you're not a gamer, but you want to play these games and get the story, this side story stuff, then grab it on your mobile or your tablet. It's so easy now. And these are not intensive action games. These are basically point and click. So on the mobile, basically, you're going to, you know, you can move around a little bit, but you're basically interacting in the story. It's an interactive story is basically what these games are.
A lot of fun with all the different choices.
Yeah, and know? So you it's a choose your own adventure game. That's basically what it is. So you choose the dialogue that you know the ends or you know the all the different dialogue answers, and it brings your character down a certain path, wherever you choose to go. So very cool. So I just wanted to put that out there. If you haven't played the games and you want to, and you're a big fan of this show, go play the games. It's on mobile. It's so accessible. Like I said, I think Clementine, if any, especially if the games just keep going. Then I think they may find a way to bring her in if those storylines merge somehow with the show. I don't know. Like I said, I haven't played the third one. I don't know where the second or third one goes at this point. So I can't speak of that. Mike is probably the only one that can speak of that because I don't think Jesse and I have gotten that far.
I'm up to the second season. I beat the second season. I haven't gotten the third yet.
All right. So you're a little farther along than I am. So
just check them out. They're a lot of fun.
Yeah. I won't get the third until I beat the second, and then I'll pick up the third. Yeah.
Clementine or Kenny will get in, and spoilers over.
Yeah, right.
Okay, cool. Moving on. So great question, though. Great question.
Yeah, that's a great one.
All right.
Yeah, it's a great one.
Number four, our fourth question from our man, Joe T, wants to know, between Alexandria, the Hilltop, and the Kingdom, do you think that they have enough men to take on Negan and the Saviors? I say we limit this to obviously just the show specifically, because we know what happens in the comic. I'll start and just say, yes, I think yes. I think they will have enough people, and I'm going to also throw in their Oceanside because obviously we don't know what's going on there, and they have guns and they have people and, you know, I think that's going to be something. So
they're there for a reason, you know, and just to specifically go with the question, because he didn't mention Oceanside.
Right.
If we don't have Oceanside,
would the three just,
right. Yeah. No, I think we can kind of agree to that. But the Oceanside episode, which we all really didn't have, weren't big fans of.
It wasn't our favorite.
But we did see the guns for a reason. We did see that they kind of know how to handle their weapons, and they have their little, like alarm system things, and their own, you know, so they're a group of women that know how to fight and take care of themselves. So they'll be an asset. So I'm assuming they were there for a reason, and we'll probably see them all grouped together.
Yeah.
They probably do. Definitely. If you add in the kingdom, they definitely have enough manpower, woman power, people power. There we go.
People power.
People power.
I like that.
But the question is not, do they have enough people? The question is, do they have enough weapons? And they have enough people, definitely. But weapons, we'll see.
Yeah. You know, you have the Hilltop. They have their spears. You have the Kingdom. They have guns, but they also wear armor. So they're kind of set up.
We don't know how much. That's the thing.
Right,
we don't
truly
even know how many men each community has.
Can I tell you the Hilltop?
We haven't spent a lot of time in the Kingdom, you know?
No.
The Hilltop, we see a few guys here and there.
But the Kingdom does seem more, though, doesn't it? The Kingdom seems like it has more, a more legit system. The Hilltop in this show is fucking all over the place.
Yeah, it seems like
it's have anything, and they don't know what the fuck they're doing, it seems like. They flip out. Yeah. So, I don't know. I think the Hilltop's going to be the weak link.
Maybe.
You know, but anyway, so I think we all think they do.
Yeah, good question.
I think they all think we do. They do. So yeah, good question, Joe. Thank you very much.
Yep. All right, so we're gonna go to our next question, which is kind of a two-parter here, because the questions had a nice to them. Yeah. So our first part of this is from Crimson Riddle, which actually wrote in a question to our last Q&A, our first one, which was very nice for them to write again. The first part is, how will Morgan and Carol deal with the news of the Saviors killing Abraham and Glenn, and will their reactions be different? Which is very cool. Do you think Carol will ever rejoin the group, and will Morgan also stay at the Kingdom? And that's from Tom. And we kind of group them together because we can kind of answer that all in one shot. But if I start off, I like the first part, the Crimson Riddle part. I really like because I do think so far in the show, we all know by watching how Carol and Morgan are reacting to the news already when not the news of killing, but the news of
Negan.
What was his name, the guy?
Richard.
Richard. When Richard, Lionheart, right, comes to them, and we see their reactions when he kind of asks them for help, and we need to fight before Negan goes after them. So we see their take on that right off the bat. So once Carol and Morgan do find out, I think both of them will really change their tune.
Yep.
I can't see one of the other saying no or yes. Especially Carol. I mean, if Carol says no, I'm going to lose probably all respect for her character because from where she evolved from way back to what a monster and a killer she turned into to now this little I just want to be left alone person, if we find out that she's going to not fight for the people that she started this world with, I'll be really, I'll be really pissed off. And, for me, quick, if Carol will ever rejoin the group and if Morgan will stay at the kingdom, I think that they'll maybe we'll see a little bit more mixture of communities after all is said and done. Maybe we'll see, Carol coming back or even Morgan staying at the kingdom. I don't think that's the biggest part of what we're going to see in this upcoming season.
You think it might be the aftermath?
I think, I think when all said and done is the biggest part is what are they going to first, how are they first going to handle the news, of Abraham and Glenn. And I'd be very, very dissatisfied if both of them even have...
Don't react the way you want.
Yeah, don't react and they don't just right away ready to change their tune, which I think they will. I think I
agree with you on that. I think I agree that I think it's going to be a call to arms for both of them. I think Carol's going to put aside her dumb fucking thing. I think she's just because she's already done it before. She's helped now twice when her group was in need. And Morgan, same thing. Morgan doesn't want to, but it'll be a call to arms. And he'll be like, okay, I got to help these people because without me, they won't be able to do it.
And just the relationships that they formed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, how can you...
Morgan has tons of respect for Rick. Yeah. Wants to see Rick succeed. Carol cares very much for those people. She's just trying to look out for herself. And I understand both of those things. As far as them going and staying, like, if you want to talk about during this whole thing, I think they're going to rejoin the group. And then possibly at the end, if we're going to end up doing a time break, and after this is all said and done, I think maybe Morgan might go to the kingdom and Carol
almost how, like, look stay. at how, like, what Maggie's doing. Maggie can be at the Hilltop, but she's Rick's.
It's group, now the, it's, I mean? It's so the Hilltop is a satellite now for them.
Yeah,
it's like,
exactly.
It's like
exactly.
That, yeah. So, Jess, what are you? You were shaking your head. Well, Pepe decides that he doesn't like.
He wants to chime in.
He doesn't agree with Jesse. I could tell you, see, because Jesse was about to disagree with us, and Pepe was like, "No."
It's like, where are all the dogs in the
zombie? How come you guys never talk about the dogs?
I don't think Carol's going to change her attitude much. I think that Morgan will be the first to change it.
Yeah.
Morgan's going to be like, they did what? Oh no. And then he's going to go back to Carol, and Carol's going to be like, it's not my lifestyle anymore. And Morgan's going to be like,
I think they will.
And then Morgan's going to convince her somehow, probably be like, those people saved your life. They've done all this stuff for you, and then you're not going to repay them, and that's what's going to happen.
And then, so you're saying initially no, but then Morgan will convince her.
And yes. Carol never seen Carol saw Carl's eyes shot out, right?
No.
Yes, she did.
There?
Yes. Yeah. That was a while ago.
Oh, I was going to say, that could be another piece, too, if, eventually Rick's group comes to the kingdom and she sees how everybody's... Carl's messed up and this, and now, Glenn and Abraham.
Finds out Maggie's pregnant,
Yeah, I can't see. Hey, I guess we have our, that's what makes the channel so good, is we have our own ideas about everything.
And I think that Carol will stay at the kingdom and Morgan won't. So see who's right on this one.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I mean, I can kind of see either of that, but I think he likes Ezekiel.
Yeah.
But then again, I think Morgan's in a transitional space where he kind of just feels like he may.
Who says either of them live?
Yeah. Good point. That's a good fucking point. Absolutely a good point. So
touche.
Yeah, touche. All right, let's go to the next one. Good questions, though. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, Crimson.
And we spoke of the seaside, Oceanside.
Oceanside, I believe, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Oceanside earlier. And this one's from Tom M. What about the women that Tara met, and what happened to Heath that was with Tara?
Yeah.
So that one, I don't know what happened to Heath. Do you guys?
I think Heath was taken by the Saviors.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I think he was taken by somebody, and I feel like it might have been the Saviors. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Or some other group. Maybe we don't see him for a while.
But see, what was
the PPP?
What?
The PPP on the card.
Oh, yeah. What the hell was that?
Yeah. I mean, didn't
Or was it DDD?
I don't know.
Well, there was a theory that I've heard.
Okay.
That if you type PPP and you Google it, it stands for some kind of radio signal or something with electronics or something like that, and it stands for like whisper.
Ooh, could that be a prelude to what's going to the the comic?
It's like possibly if you Google it, it says something to do like it's like a whispering signal. I don't know. I could be wrong about the radio thing, but I know that I remember hearing that it has to do with whispering. So, I don't know if without getting crazy into this question
That's
like
an
that,
interesting
talking
thing.
About, yeah. But I remember seeing a video about that, and then that's what it translates to, the PPP thing. Maybe we won't see him for a while if it is in fact, you know, the whisperers.
Spoilers. The thing is Heath. No one fucking cares. Like you're not a character that's. You're on the outskirts of everything, and I don't even know why wasting fucking valuable screen time, unless the story is going to pay off in the long run. But now you're
that's
doing something.
That's what I'm thinking.
But now you're doing something that they really haven't done. Let's be honest. Yeah. They haven't really done this whole Twin Peaks type situation where it's like, oh, let's, you know, what in two different, in like next season, the season after that, like when, maybe. You know what I'm saying? Like you're going to really do that? I don't know. As far as Oceanside is concerned, the question was, what about the women Tara met? We kind of addressed that. We hope that they join the fight. I hope that Tara tells everyone about them and that they them to help.
Yeah,
you know.
We
don't have enough weapons. Oh, wait, guys, by the way, I met a bunch of crazy women in the woods that have guns.
Yeah.
So,
I agree.
You know.
I agree.
So, yeah, I think
good.
Yeah. That's it. Jess? Anything to that or?
No, I actually agree with you guys. I don't know what's happening with Heath. Maybe it's who's coming up in the comics, but I did a quick Google search while you were saying that. PPP stands for something completely different than that. It's like Point Power Productions or something like that. So
PowerPoint
no.
presentation?
No, Point Power or something.
They say they're gonna do a PowerPoint presentation to show them where Keith
maybe
is.
That's what it
maybe.
Is. Maybe that's what it was. There's a hotel key card. That's like
yeah,
to the.
Yeah.
All
right.
Yeah.
Well, again,
we'll see. I mean,
Heath,
we'll
I don't give a shit. Sorry, Heath. I don't care.
His comic character's good.
Yeah, he's all right.
We'll say that his comic character's good.
All right. Let's move to the next one. So what are we on? Number seven, right? This is a quick one. This is a good one. This is from one of our viewers and got a question in the last time too, Kate. And she asks, what is Negan going to do when he finds out about Daryl? Meaning, what happens when he finds out that Daryl has escaped and is back with his group? Simple. He's going to be fucking pissed. And he's going to fucking iron somebody's face.
I think that's going to be the spark.
Yeah.
You know? That's going to be that major spark.
That's going to send them to be like, that's it. We're fucking attacking you.
This is the war. Yeah.
Okay.
I think that because obviously after, you know, after the everybody reuniting in the Hilltop, Rick was quick to want to go back and be like, yo, we got to prepare because this dude is going to, you know what I mean?
Right.
And that's when Jesus kind of stepped in. Hey, we can have a couple steps ahead of them because we can listen
we
to them on
other,
the walkie-talkie
and
blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think that's going to be, you know, Maybe they'll find Fat Tommy or Fat Joey or whatever first, and maybe they'll get, you know, two and two together or something. But yeah, I think that's going to be the beginning of the war, of the first upcoming battle, you know?
I gotcha.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't know. He's of course going to lose it, maybe, but I want to take the approach that he might not, and if he doesn't, maybe he just didn't care, and that was just a game to him.
Maybe, but I yeah, he was a bargaining chip.
Not really.
You don't think so? For like against Rick?
Nah.
Or he was just using. It was a game. It's a fucking game.
And... It was a game. Remember, Negan likes his games.
Yeah, but he's just like what he sees in Daryl, his fighting spirit, you know, his strength. He saw in Carl. You know what I mean? I think that I guess we'll see. But I think that Negan truly thought that he can maybe change Daryl and break him down. I don't necessarily think it was
make
a bargaining
him make
chip.
Him like
maybe he can turn
make
him
like Dwight.
You know.
Put him in Dwight's position.
Maybe. And then, you know, Negan's whole act is that whole scare tactic thing. That whole, you know, I'm 50 steps ahead of you. I'm going to do the most vile things, you know, in front of you. Like when I'm with Sherry and you're Dwight and you're standing right there. And he's mind games. So, Jesse, you could be right. It could just be like, you know, whatever he was planning on using Daryl for, possibly a bargaining chip, but I don't think that's going to be the case. I think that, I think Negan's going to want payback, just like he wants payback for anything. Rosita, you know, Rosita shoots at him. What happens? You know what I mean? Daryl blows up Negan's men on the road. What happens? You know what I mean? So we'll see. You know, we'll definitely see.
Definitely. So have all three of us answered that question?
Dang. Can you guys hear me? Good.
Yes.
Yeah, I hear you. Right.
Did you hear me when I asked my wife something? No? Good.
No.
All right, good. I couldn't unmute my mic. All right. Yeah, that's good. Yeah. All right. Yeah. I think we're good with that. What do we got next?
I think we're going to number 8.
We got number 8. Okay, let's go.
Number 8
is from Alyssa Jett, which is one of our big followers as well. She says, hey, guys, do you think...
And if we're saying your name wrong, we apologize. Just let us know.
I believe that's, you know.
Could be either one.
It's either Alyssa or Elisa.
Right.
Well, yeah, I would think it's Alyssa. I don't think we can really mess that up, right? All right, anyway. hey, guys, do you think or want Daryl getting his crossbow back?
Yes.
Jesse, you want to start this one? Yes, I think, yeah.
Yes, he will.
Of course.
We want and he will.
I want him to.
He absolutely will.
The question is, the only way he will is to either kill Dwight or Dwight hands it over willingly.
Let's be honest, Dwight's defecting. Dwight isn't around. Yes. Dwight's defecting. Dwight is actually probably at the kingdom right now.
Probably.
Yeah.
So, without delving too much into it, in the comics, Dwight uses a gun mostly after he defects from Negan.
Right.
Yeah.
Because he states that the crossbow is too ineffective or something along those lines.
Yeah.
So... And he hasn't stopped using it since.
Right.
So maybe he trades out that crossbow for a weapon. Or actual weapon, an assault rifle.
Yeah. But yeah, I think that's what's gonna he's definitely getting his
crossbow. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
It's iconic, and why not? Why not give your heroes their icon?
Well,
Rick got his back, right? Rick
that's
got his
true.
Fucking hand cannon back, so there you go.
He got his mojo back. So
now
Daryl's
I want him to get that red machete back. That red handled machete.
Oh yeah. I like the axe, though.
Well, if we want to go on the... Hatchet. If we still want to stick with the idea that Dwight was the one that let Daryl out and left the key to the bike, his bike, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
If that's almost Daryl saying... Dwight saying, here, brother, here's your bike back.
If
that is the case, I think we'll probably see that right away.
Yeah.
That Dwight will do the same with
absolutely. Cool. All right, cool. Good question. Next question.
Number 9.
Yeah, I'm a 9. This is another one from Kate. Do you think it will take a lot of convincing for Ezekiel to team up and fight the Saviors? I'll start off real quick by saying yes and no. I think it's going to take an episode. I think it's going to take, it's going to, it's not going to happen till
quick for The Walking Dead. If it's just
yeah.
Up, so.
Well, I think they're going to move this along. And I think that, it's going to be like in the beginning, Ezekiel's going to give him all this hot winded words of, well, you know, I built this, I did this, we are this, I'm trying to do this, we have this going for them, blah, blah, blah. Meanwhile, you're going to have Richard. Yeah, he may even say, I know that, you know, my right-hand man wants me to do it, blah, 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 and Rick's going to have to convince him. So I guess so the answer, short answer is yeah. I think it'll take a little bit of convincing, but in the end, it won't, he's just going to be like, okay, yeah, let's just fucking do this. We're doing this. You know, that's what I think.
Well, jumping on, you actually kind of sparked something with the whole Richard thing with that. Now, because we see Richard not going to Ezekiel in the first place, instead of, you know what I mean? So that goes to show you, from someone who lives within the confines of the kingdom and works along with Ezekiel, who he could be his right-hand man for the most part, his second in charge. If he couldn't even go to Ezekiel and say this and try to persuade him, maybe he did, but maybe Ezekiel in the past has
right,
said,
what I'm
no,
saying.
No,
maybe,
no, no.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He was like, no, Lionheart,
so
we
it
shall
will
not.
Definitely be, yeah. So it might not be as easy as we think.
Well, that's my
some
point.
Stranger.
I think
exactly.
He's going to respect Rick.
I agree with you too.
Excuse me. Yeah. So what do you think, Jeff?
We'll see.
I think it's going to be longer than it should be for us, but shorter than it normally is for The Walking Dead.
So it's that sweet spot. Do you think there's going to be this spot there? Yeah, okay. Yeah.
It's going to be too long for most people to enjoy, but it's going to be short enough that, it's The Walking Dead. We can live with it.
Yeah. Okay, cool. We'll move on. Next one.
Yes, number 10 is from Alyssa Chet again. Daryl, Carol, Sasha, and Morgan were not part of All Out War storyline. How do you think those characters might change the story going into these battles with Negan? Now, Daryl doesn't exist in the comics, and Carol, for the most part, now does not exist in the comics because she died way back in season 3 for us at the prison. Sasha doesn't exist in the comics, right?
Right.
No, and Morgan's been dead for a while.
Right.
Well, not a while, but a good bit of time.
So all of these characters do not exist at this point in time.
At the present time in the comics.
At the time of the what's about to happen in the show. Right.
Yeah.
I think, being as they're taking the place of a few of the Alexandrians, I believe. More or less. Well, they take a place of a few other characters, such as Holly and all the rest of them. Maybe they turn the tide of the battle and it's not as gruesome as it was in the comics, which I hope to God that does not happen.
Yeah.
I mean, for me, if Daryl dies, we riot, right? So yeah. Daryl's not going anywhere. He's going to be a pivotal part of the upcoming battle. Like, we went back for the earlier question with the whole Carol thing. What will she, you know, how will she deal with the news of Abraham and Glenn? I think she's going to end up turning into a monster again, like she always will, and she'll have some kind of big role in the war as well. When it comes to Sasha, like we spoke about, that maybe Sasha was getting that Holly character from the comic. I could see Sasha and even Morgan possibly dying in this battle. You know, obviously without getting too far, because I'm not as far, like we say it a million times, I'm not as far as you guys, in the big battle with Negan.
Right.
But on Walking Dead, we see it every season. We see it every within the last, you know, 6-7 years since the show started, that characters kind of drop. And we've almost become numb to some of them.
We have a lot now. We have a lot.
Yeah.
We have a lot
and
of
that's
characters.
True.
Like a lot
I think
of
we're going to see
main.
You know.
Yeah.
I can definitely see Sasha. I just have this thing about Sasha. I think she's going to she's not going to be with us
she's
much
on the way
longer.
Out.
And I can see
Cannon major, fodder.
Yeah, well, I can see a major character as well, not to the level of a Rick or a Carl or Daryl or Michonne kind of thing, but I could see Morgan maybe biting it too, you know.
Maybe.
Yeah,
I think are they going to change the story going into the battle? right? They're going to change the story. I think all of these characters are proven fighters. They're proven allies. And I think they're very important, and I think they're some of the strongest characters on the show, regardless of whether you like them for whatever reasons or not. Yeah. They kick ass. They know how to get shit done. They've saved people. They've maintained the status quo for people. Like, they're important characters. To me, they're important characters. Okay? I think...
Okay there, Captain Kirk.
Yeah. But no, but I'm serious, and I think that those having those four... specifically in the battle will absolutely change, not change, but it's going to help the good guys. Yeah, is it going to change the story?
Someone's going to.
If it's going to, well, that's, but that's besides the point. I mean, if we're going to say someone's dying, yeah, probably someone's going to die. I don't know who. We'll get.
No,
we'll...
but I mean, as far as what would happen if we go into this big, if we go into this battle, okay, and we have the Alexandrians, we have the Kingdom people, we have the Hilltop, we have even Oceanside. If just these little CB kind of level characters die and nobody significant dies.
I agree. Someone will die, but let me ask you this though. Do you
That's why I think does, someone major.
Right, but knowing essentially what happens at the end of this arc, does it really matter who it is that dies? Overall for the story. Because the question specifically says could they change the story going into these battles? And the answer to me is no. I don't think that any of these characters, are they important? Will they make a difference? Yes, because we have a different dynamic in the show than we do in the comics. Ultimately, it's going to end up, unless they do not follow the comic, in which case, spoiler alert, they kill Negan. Okay?
We spoke about this a lot. We spoke about, and one of my things, you guys know, I said it a million times, is how long are they going to drag the battle out? Right? If it's multiple mini battles, if it's one huge war, we don't know yet.
Right.
And I think that's still going to, it's all going to come down to that.
It's going to be great though when it does.
Negan will be around, you know?
But when we do find out after this first battle, whether it be the first and or last, I think we're going to get an idea. And that's going to be a really good episode that we talk about. It's going to be, because we're going to have so much to talk about that. And I'm really looking forward to that. But anyway.
We only got a month. A month, 5 weeks, you know, it's before you know it, we'll be doing our reaction.
We'll be getting into that. Jesse, real quick, what do you think about that?
I think I've already stated it, but
did you? I don't remember.
They're not going to have that much of an impact. And if they do comic spoilers again, kill Negan, then I'm going to be sorely disappointed because his character is such a good character. And the only way I could see them justify doing it is if Morgan's the one to say, Rick, you need to kill him.
Yeah. All right. So cool. That's all right. So that's that question. That's what we think about that. What are we on? Number 11?
Think about that.
That's what we think about.
11.
Yeah. Number 11. Our biggest fan on our YouTube channel. I think we could say that with 100% certainty.
Right. Yeah. Yes.
Another question from Melissa. It's kind of a big question, so we'll try to get through this as easy as we can. One thing that she finds interesting about The Walking Dead is that we get to see many different kinds of leaderships in the zombie apocalypse. There's the Ricks, the Negans, the Governors, and the Hilltops.
Kingdom.
They all, and the Kingdoms as well. The weaknesses and strengths behind them all. It seems that the Governor, for the most part, just took care of a lot of people and kept them in the dark about what was going on in Woodbury. He did not respect the rebellion against him like Negan does, but seemed to want weaker members around him to control. Welcome the idea of a kiss-ass like Spencer taking over for Rick's position. The question is about Negan, and she says, and the Governor's ways. Who would you call more evil, and whose rule would you want to live under?
It's a good question.
It's a good question. Obviously, we do see that there's many different ways that everybody handles the control and the power. You know, we see Rick. We've seen Rick evolve. We see from the Governor's character, and just like she says, with everybody, you know, and we see how that's what makes the show great. Because you're seeing it from everybody else's eyes, and what would possibly you do in situations like that? We haven't dove too much into the kingdom. From what we see, it seems like a great community. They had their goats and their farming and this and that, and we've seen that.
They trust Ezekiel. They trust him to do right by them. He's also lying to them, though. So we can't brush past that. He is keeping, but different than the governor. You know.
But in all, you know, there are similarities in the farming kind of thing. Rick tried to do that whole stuff, you know, with the prison and this and that. I mean, since we know so much and we started with Rick, I would have to say I would like to be, you know, with Rick and with how Rick handles his group. The governor masked a lot of things, you know. So I guess, you know.
Well, now she's asking. The question is about Negan and the governor. Who would you want to live under?
Which one of those would you?
Yeah, no, I know. So, I mean, if I had to make a choice, it would probably have to be the governor. You know, if the governor didn't, if Rick, who knows what would have happened if Rick's group didn't come across them? They could still be in Woodbury, hanging out. You know,
if it wasn't Rick's group, it would have been someone else.
It's a possibility, but he made them feel safe in the way that they, like you said, they didn't necessarily know. They weren't given all the info.
Now, who's more evil?
You know, I've said this. I've actually said this before in previous episodes, and I think the difference between Negan and the governor is that Negan's a bastard. All right, yeah. Negan's like a sociopath. Okay, he's got some very violent tendencies, but he's straightforward. He knows what he wants, and he knows what he has to do to get there. The governor was fucked in the head, okay? And there are reasons for that, but he was completely cracked. And his way was subterfuge and manipulation, whereas Negan is not. Negan is like, do this or and be good, or don't, and get punished. The governor, again, was just this all this mind games and shit. So for me, the governor's way was definitely more evil, and because the governor was a guy that you didn't know, you never knew what you were going to get. You didn't know if you were going to get him on a good day or a bad day. Because here's the thing: the governor had his daughter, all right, trapped. You know,
technically,
it actually wasn't even his daughter. It's actually his niece. It actually, wasn't his daughter.
In the comics, now in the show, it's actually his daughter.
That's what I'm saying, but technically, whatever. The point, I'm so stuck on the comics and the book. The book, it was his, it's actually his niece, his brother's daughter.
Yeah.
He actually takes his brother's name. His real name isn't Philip. I forget his name in the book. In the comic story, his real name is not Philip. It's something else.
Isn't it Blake?
Yeah. I think, maybe. But the point is that he takes his brother's identity because his brother was the one that he ends up becoming. Really, really fucking fantastic story. You should just read those novels. They're really great.
Yeah.
Bottom line is, you never knew what you were going to get. Negan, on the other hand, and I think if I had to choose, I'd pick Negan's way. Because if you knew what you were going to get. If you did your job and whatever, you knew what you were going to get. You know, you might get promoted. Rewarded.
You don't get
but
punished.
But they're all spontaneous in the fact that they can just turn around and just, you know.
Right.
You never know. You know what I mean? Right. The whole governor, why I say possibly the governor is because, you know, for the most part, it was like a smoke and mirrors thing. You know what I mean? These people were having picnics and parties. And for the most part, for, you know, a long while, it was like Green Acres. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Negan leads by fear and punishment and until, like I said, until the governor had some kind of foes and adversaries, for the most part, you know, it seemed, you know, with their lemonade and their tea and their eggs in the morning, you know what I mean?
What do you think, Jess?
So the governor is more sadistic. By the way, quick Google search. It's Brian. Brian Blake was his alias when he was talking with Tara and them.
Right, yeah. Yeah, that's but, right. That's right. Because I was like, oh, yeah, that's supposed to be his real name. Got it.
Yeah, he read it off somebody.
Yeah.
So he's more sadistic, obviously. So I'm counting him more evil than Negan because who guns down their own people like that?
Exactly.
Sure, Negan kills them. He brands them. But he didn't mow down 20 people.
He doesn't kill them. He just no. he makes examples.
He tells other people to kill them.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So Negan, like, not as evil. Right. I'm putting that out there now.
I agree. I'd like to live under Negan. He's not evil. He's just a sadistic bastard.
And he's not sadistic. He's manipulative.
And a different way. Definitely. Yeah, exactly. But definitely in a different way than the governor was. They're both manipulative assholes.
If you want, they're both comparing evil. Them to a different comic, he's Kilgrave.
Okay. Who, wait, the governor is or? No, Negan.
Negan's Kilgrave.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely like Kilgrave. Yeah.
Yeah. So, for those of you who don't know, he's in the Marvel universe and he can manipulate people with saying words.
Yeah. But yeah, much I'd like Maeve can now.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, go on.
Negan. I'd like to live under Negan.
Yeah. That's... Okay, cool. Yeah. Good question, though. But yeah, I mean, what's the lesser of two evils? You know,
yeah.
But seriously. I think I go back and agree with Mike is his initial answer. With you know, under Rick.
Well, you know, we already know the conclusion of the governor. We don't know what's going to be the conclusion of the saviors.
Right, right.
So if you were just to put both of them side by side, and you took a screenshot of Woodbury at its peak before the Rick take, you know, kind of, and you take, you know, the saviors who are in a factory, and you know what I mean.
But it would only have been a matter of time anyway. Like Jesse said, it would have been a matter of time before
the saviors.
Yeah.
What if you were those poor bastards that Rick took out in the satellite group? You know.
Yeah. True. Yeah.
Like,
look, nobody's right. They're just trying to survive. It's whoever. Because I bet you there are people out there that love that don't know the comic that love Negan and love his way, or people that love the governor. And I used to know people who loved the governor on the show and thought that he was awesome.
He was a great actor. I thought
great actor.
Well, everyone on the show does an amazing job. They pick the right people. But anyway, okay. Listen, we're winding down here, guys. A couple more. Yeah, that's the bulk of what we got for the show specifically. We got a couple more questions left, and these are kind of fun questions based on you know, how we personally feel about things about the show and outside the show. So let's go to the next one.
Alrighty. Who is your favorite and least favorite character? That's by Alyssa Jett. And since we were talking about characters, perfect timing.
Exactly.
So I'm going to save mine for last because it's not what you expect.
Okay. Damn it. Mike, do you have anything?
Go ahead. My favorite character is Rick. I mean, I have a lot of great, you know, you guys know how I am with the whole
thing. I hate seeing him like this.
Yeah, I hate him. I hated seeing him like weak and all this, you know, and that whole Daryl handing over the Python again was just great. But I mean, obviously there's some great characters. So just to pin, you know, just to say one specific character is your favorite is very difficult because there's a lot of good ones that we can choose from.
Yeah.
But I'll stick with Rick as my favorite and my least favorite. As of right now, I'm not a fan of Tara and some of these lesser characters that, you know, it's kind of tough. It's kind of tough. But Carol's bothering me. No matter how much I love Carol.
Yeah.
Carol's killing me right now. If you're going to say right now, I can't stand Carol and the going from, you know, one of the most strongest part of Rick's, you know, group of soldiers to just this whole leave me alone kind of shit and I'm forgetting about everybody else. So I'm not liking her right now.
I'm adding to the question, who's your favorite and least favorite comic character?
Jesus.
Without getting into all, you know.
Without getting too deep into detail, who's your least favorite and who's your favorite?
Oh, damn it.
But you didn't answer. Oh, you answered your least favorite. Yeah.
Yeah. You take that, Chris.
Well, I'll tell you, for the show, I actually think my most favorite character is Michonne. Fucking love Michonne. I love it. I love Danae's fucking portrayal of her. I just love what she does. I've loved who she's become in the show. I thought she's always had a really cool backstory, comic wise and in the show. So Michonne is also one of my favorite in the comic. So
yeah, she's doubles. Probably one of my favorites in the comic.
She doubles for me in the comic.
Kill two birds, one stone.
Yeah, but you know, I always thought that. I loved seeing her stuff in the comic. And when we got her backstory in the show and everything, like I love her. And I love that they're giving her more lines, like that they're, that she's speaking more, because she used to never, you know, she used to be very, you know, stoic. And yeah. And then, you know, and now she's like become this, this.
Well, she's Rick's.
This, yeah.
Chick.
This, yeah. You know, and I just love it. And I love hearing her speak. I don't know why I love the character so much. And I love that with the katana, and she's just fucking badass. She's just a fucking badass. Yeah, I love it, man.
Yeah.
Least favorite in the show is Morgan. Unlike Carol, I don't know. Carol, for some reason, I can see. I don't know why. I give Carol more leeway in her decisions as to not do certain stuff. Morgan, I don't.
They're very similar.
But I was tied with Morgan, but before Carol started her shit, like Morgan's just like, I just don't want to. No, asshole, you have the skills, you're doing it. Carol, yeah. I mean, Carol's annoying because she took everything upon herself and then decides she doesn't want to do it anymore. But Morgan, yeah. I don't know. Morgan's annoying to me. Morgan's annoying. Yeah. I like the. It's very hard because the character's a really cool character, and any character that can handle their own, you know, that can literally take out a group of humans and or walkers at the same time, like mm-hmm. that's fucking awesome. You know, I want to give a runner up though is Jesus. Fucking love Jesus in the show. So fucking awesome. I have to mention he comes in as definitely honorable mention. Yeah. I think a show or side show with Jesus and Michonne. Fuck. Jesus. Are you kidding me?
Without giving too much,
they need to name it Jesus and Friends.
Play the new Telltale.
Oh, God. All right. I have to play the Michonne one too. Guys, they also have a mini series of Michonne. Have you played that, Mike?
Yeah.
I didn't play the mini of.
Are you going to?
Possibly. I'm just kind of excited about the new season 3.
Episodes,
right? I've beaten it like probably three different.
But there's only two episodes, right?
Yeah, it's not even that long either.
They're going to give more though. They haven't.
There's five.
So there's three more coming. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it was, and it's fairly cheap too. Is another thing. Quick, compared to some of these other games.
Yeah.
Well, it was $25 for the season pass.
For the season pass, which gets you you're basically all buying. Yeah, it's.
Well, they had a sale on one of the websites, and it's gone
well, regardless,
now.
Regardless, it's significantly cheaper.
It's
than
a good.
A
yeah, you're
game.
Getting a game at essentially a quarter of the price or half of the price. You know, a little less than half the price of a normal $60 game. Point is. Yeah, I want to get to those two. So, but those are my the thing. Comic character. I you know what I'm gonna say? I'm gonna say these fucking lesser characters in the comics. Some of these women that show up. I don't know who any of these fucking people are. Jesse makes fun of me because I can't tell who the fuck is who in the comic because everyone kind of looks the fucking same. And when it cuts to a scene and it's this dude with this brownish hair wearing a flannel, and I'm like, but that isn't that the same fucking dude from the like? I can't.
Did he teleport? He was on the hilltop a second ago.
Who the hell? You know. But anyway, yes, I don't really have some of those lesser characters. I have to group them all together because they're kind of annoying. It's like, shut up. You're annoying. Anyway, okay, Jesse, go ahead. So.
All right. So you guys know that I actually really like Daryl a lot.
Yeah.
But he's not my favorite character.
Okay.
All right.
It's actually Jesus. Good. Then Daryl and then Morgan.
All right. So
that's my favorite show character. Followed by the runners-ups. My least favorite, and it's no surprise here, Andrea.
Oh, yeah. Can I tell you, I didn't
even...
If we're going back, I think we all pick fucking Andrea.
Lori is like the ultimate.
Oh, God, Lori was so fucking annoying, too.
yeah, okay.
That's my man, Rick up.
Season 2, when she wrecks the freaking car with a walker on the road.
Oh, that's true.
Andrew, that's when Andrew's like, oh, you took the girl's car and you didn't even say sorry.
And that's what I hated about the. I hated Andrew in that scene, too.
Oh, yeah.
And it's a tie between those two, honestly.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Fuck, man.
Comic character? I really like Eugene's comic character.
Yeah, he's good.
Straying away from main cast here because everybody's going to say Rick and stuff, but Eugene's really my favorite comic character.
Yeah. He's cool.
Least favorite comic character?
He's got a dope-ass ponytail, that's for sure.
Yeah.
That's for
least favorite comic character is probably Rosita.
Okay. I could see that.
You see why she is.
Well, yeah, she's a piece of shit.
she also screwed over Eugene.
That's what I'm saying. She turns out to be a piece of shit. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And that's essentially, yeah, there's your pair right there, because she screwed over your favorite character. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, cool. Cool, guys. All right. So that was fun. I like that.
All righty. Mike, we got one more question.
Yeah. One more outside the realm of the actual show. It's our last question.
My favorite question.
Yeah.
I think this is the reason a majority of the country and even the world watch this show to begin with.
Yeah.
Is this next question. What would each of us do in the zombie apocalypse if the zombie apocalypse were to happen? Sometimes when watching the show, you can catch yourself thinking about what you have done. And my thing is sometimes all the time, you know. Yeah. I think that's what makes the show
This question from again?
So great. Oh, this is Alyssa also.
Okay.
Alyssa gave us quite a bit of questions, and we'll try to get to the other ones that we missed. But we obviously wanted to take some of what we felt were the significant, substantial questions from her now. So Alyssa, definitely check out on the channel, and we'll try to get to some of those other ones. Yep. Like I said, this is what makes us love the show, is because you can be walking, shopping or something and saying, oh, this would be great, or this weapon would be great, or
yeah,
happen to.
Yeah. I think I can hide out in there. Like,
I would do is grab all, you know, you know, grab this stuff, or first place we're going to. I think everybody has those kind of things. Where are we going to go? Which stores are we going to go?
What supplies am I going to grab?
Most populated, where we can survive the beginning, because you know, it's going to be all out chaos and war if this was, God forbid, to ever happen, especially in the first few weeks, first months, because there's going to be a lot of people still running around wanting everything, and the stores are going to be looted and everything like that. So yeah, you know, stock up on your bullets, you know what I mean? But yeah, it's a great question, and obviously who knows? I always say that out here on Long Island, it would be a killer to even leave. It's like almost impossible to leave the island because there's only a couple.
You guys are screwed.
Yeah, we're kind of screwed. So I always said the highest elevated place on the island is the dumps, Chris.
Yeah, that is true. That is true.
We got so much shit going on.
If you guys didn't know, if you didn't catch some of the other videos, or when we don't normally talk about it, but Mike and I live in the same location. Mike and I went to high school together, junior high. Actually, we've known each other for a long time.
We did driver's ed together.
Yeah, we used to do driver's ed and stuff. So Mike and I have known each other for a very long time. So we live in the same location. So for us, and we live on what's considered. It's not considered. It is an island. It's a very big island, Long Island, essentially. It's the name of
it's very difficult to get off.
So we're surrounded. We're literally surrounded by water, and the bridges that get us there are a handful of major bridges that get us over to Manhattan, which itself is an island. So for us to actually get to a mainland, we have to cross. There's nothing south of us unless we go south, like southwest, to hit Jersey, right?
And you don't want to go to Jersey.
And then it's
a bitch. It would be a bitch to get off. Yeah. Unless
do they know we're in New York? Do they know Long Island's in New York?
I hope so.
Long Island's in New York.
I really hope so.
That's the point. Yeah. That's what we're talking about. So but we can get to Manhattan, which is an island. If you guys watch or have read the Strain books, you understand that's a horrible place to be in some type of pandemic. Then to get over there, you have Pennsylvania and stuff like that. And like I said, Jersey. We go south. If we want to hit the water, we'd have to go up to Connecticut and Maine and Rhode Island, but we have to get in the water and we have to cross the water.
So that's why we need a pilot or a captain of a ship or one of us gets our fucking ferry license or something. Yeah, hopefully we're like upstate in the mountains if this, God forbid, ever happened, that we don't have to worry too much. We're already where we need to be.
Yeah.
Or you know? Maybe like one of you guys is down here with me.
Yeah, right. No, but to finish off my little point of it is I always felt, and you guys know, I always loved season two, The Farm, and to ride it out, especially in the beginning, I always said, because I do have a place upstate with my family, and I would wish I was there, you know,
if
God forbid, because like we just said that it's like almost impossible to get off the island anyway, if anything, God forbid, was to happen. So I'd like to be probably upstate somewhere, and I'll worry about everything when I get there.
For me, I think I have, obviously, I have a wife and I have kids that don't live with me. So I would, I do the same thing you do, Mike, you know, and I'm a mailman. So I walk and I'm in neighborhoods all the time. I see all these things. I see that stuff a lot. Yeah. You know what? I'm the first to go.
First to go.
Oh my God. I'd probably get attacked. Right. Yeah. I'd be the first to know. Let's put it that way. Right? You guys would agree with that? I'd probably be the first to know.
I might be the first to know.
Oh, you work in a hospital. Yeah, you might be the first.
I might be the first one dead, too.
That's true. So if it goes down, Mike, you're going to have to call me and be like, Chris, what are you seeing out there on the street? Because they got people coming in. But you don't work in the emergency room, though.
Well, I do. I'm all over that bitch.
Are you? Okay, so, all right. So you might. Okay, so between the two of us, and then so we'd have to call Jesse and be like, Jesse, it's on. Gather your shit, gather your gear, come up and get us and help us, or we'll meet you somewhere.
Well, I got to swoop down to Florida first.
Oh, no, he can come up, man. He's got a fucking... He can come
I got
up.
Family down there.
Oh, you have family down. Okay, you got to go to Florida. Okay. Where would we go? We wouldn't go south.
We go north, man.
We'd have to go north.
Zombies move slower. We'd have to go into the mountains.
We'd have to go... So I'd want to, grab my children. Like,
we'd go up to Canada.
Forget their mom. Oh, we'll go visit our friend Gillen.
Oh, there
we'll
you go.
There you go. He's got room. Yeah, you know, the thing is, yeah, we all have family. We have family. Like, I have family in Florida. I have family in Carolina. I have family, you know, I have family on the island. Most of my family is on the island, you know, so, but like, what are you going to do? Like, what do you do?
It's going to be impossible to get everybody, you know?
Yeah.
You're just going to have to hope. Yeah, you're going to have to hope.
But it'd take you longer to get back. See, that's dangerous, man. You'd have to get down there and then have to get back.
I got a truck.
Yeah,
I got a good truck on good gas mileage.
Yeah, but so do many other people, though, you know?
Screw them. I'll take their truck.
Yeah. Oh, you know, here's a good question. And it's funny because my wife and I talk about this all the time. And she's funny because she's like, I don't think I wouldn't be able to do those things in the apocalypse. And I'm like, I would fucking kill everybody. I'm sorry. I would not hesitate. To kill a
if
human
it's
being.
If me or you, I'm shooting you.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
You know, I wouldn't, you know, obviously if it's someone I know, it's a friend of mine and stuff.
Not like me and you, but right. Like me and
but,
you.
Yeah, if it's between me and someone else preventing me, and I wouldn't, and honestly, I wouldn't expect it to be different than any other people. Now, but having said that, if you're trying to help me or if you're not impeding my way, I can help you. I will. I'm not saying I'm going to go on a fucking killing spree, but I will not let somebody prevent me.
That's
from,
a waste of bullets.
Right. Yeah. From keep, you know, from taking the people I care about and getting into
that's
safety.
That's what goes on to what kind of character you'd end up becoming.
Yeah. I would. If I had to, absolutely. Yeah. I wouldn't do it willy nilly.
Maybe I'd be a Rick.
But if I, had to, I think I would end up being a Rick. That I would.
I hope so too.
If anything, my personality is more of a leadership role anyway. And I have a pretty decent amount of common sense and, you know, survival, you know, some people can and some people can't. And I think I can. I think I would last a lot longer than a lot of other people. Let's put it that way. But I would definitely be ruthless. I would be as good a person as I can, but I would definitely be ruthless. And I wouldn't trust. You really can't trust anybody.
Yeah.
You really can't. You know, and that's the scariest part about this, you know, because look, once you learn how to handle zombies, you know how to fucking handle zombies. You're not going to get anything different unless we're talking about like from Left 4 Dead or from 28 Days Later. Yeah. If we're talking about like it depends on the type of virus. If you're talking about a deteriorating virus that turns people into cannibal type people.
Yeah.
The actual zombies. Yeah. Brain, you know, barely functioning zombies. Mm. That's one thing. But if you're talking about maniacs. Like 28 days
smokers,
later.
Smokers, boomers.
Yeah, you know, if
like
you're
that.
Talking about these mutated humans that are fast and chasing you and spitting shit on you, like, that is scary. That's a scary fucking prospect. Okay? I don't think any of us are surviving that long hit with those fucking things.
I've been playing H1Z1 lately. And
right,
that game, you have a smoker in there. And the thing is, zombies in this game transfer from regular zombies to runners. Then to smokers, then to exploders, and then they go to something else.
And why would zombies explode? I mean, that's not something that would most likely happen in a real life situation.
Build up inside the intestines.
True, but not the way in these games though. Like they don't.
Well, it wouldn't be expelled, so that means that the gas would build up over time, and then
Boom. Make sure you don't watch it, shoot them when you're in close proximity.
Exactly.
But yeah, that'd be pretty crazy though. That would be insane. That would just be fucking insane if it was that type of thing. Then you're looking at something crazy. But yeah, I would definitely be someone that would, I would do it. I wouldn't be so, you know, quick to trust people.
I wouldn't say I'm a Rick. I'm more of a Daryl, because I don't want to be a leader.
Survivalist.
Yeah.
You're definitely a survivalist. Yeah.
And now my answer.
Move that mic back.
Uh-oh.
So this is answer number one. This is answer number two.
Good job. Nice.
This is answer number three.
There you go.
All right. I
have more answers. Well, actually about 30 more answers.
30 more answers. I was
including this one. Which, there we go.
There you go.
So 33 answers.
He's got 33 answers on how to survive.
Plus roughly 750 more.
God damn, man. Well, Jesse, off camera, we were talking about, I asked him if he has a bandolier. Would he be able to like put all those knives on like a bandolier?
Yes.
And he said, yeah. So, you know.
That's true. We can just get a lot of broomsticks and just tape all of Jesse's knives to the end of them.
Exactly.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I've got a couple, but not as many as Jesse. I've got like a couple, and I've got a couple of swords.
Yeah.
Some are decorative, but
I have a drawer here filled with knives.
Yeah.
Next to me at all times.
Yeah.
Don't break into his house.
Jesse, there's something coming behind through the screen behind you. You might want to just put a knife behind your head. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Don't worry.
So, and Jesse, you also said you'd end up having to get down to Florida and grab some people.
My plan would be, because I'm in Georgia right now. Big surprise. Not many people between me and my destination. Head down to Florida, grab some family, grab some friends, move on up north.
Your best bet is probably just to stay in one spot. You got less people around you.
Nah. All the gun nuts are down here, and that's the people I'd have to contend with. I'd go up north where you guys don't have any.
Yeah.
Oh, well. I
wouldn't They're up there.
I wouldn't go that far.
Yeah, they're definitely up there.
Well, all right, so I'd probably go, say, Kansas first, pick up one of our friends. Then I'd swing to New York, pick you up. Probably Brooklyn to pick up.
Hop, skip, and a jump.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, I got a vehicle to do all this.
Yeah.
So
we'd probably meet you somewhere in Pennsylvania.
It's fun. Yeah, it's fun.
Well, we're going up north to Canada where the zombies are slow and the people are easy to pick up.
Right, but it's more or less a straight shot west to get into Pennsylvania, and then we can head up north. Because also, if we're going to go visit our friend Gillen up where he lives, he's on the east coast, more or less, of Canada. Or Eastern Canada. He's like, because he's only like an hour behind
us. And
so
if we see any of you up there, good luck.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah,
make sure you write this stuff down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Write this stuff down. You find us, you might just live.
Yeah. So I think we'd be okay.
I'd be more of a Daryl though.
More of a Daryl. Yeah. I think I'd definitely be like a Rick to, you know, because.
Or it could be a Eugene.
Me or you?
No, me.
You'd be more,
making a joke there. Comic Eugene, not book or not show Eugene.
Not show Eugene, yeah. No, I think we know you're not a show Eugene.
Hey.
But I don't know, man. It's fun. It's definitely
fun.
And it's fun. Like I said, my wife and I talk about it all the time. And I'd be like, don't worry, I got you, babe. Well,
That's what makes the show so much fun. We can, you know, we have these conversations with all of our friends, I'm sure, that watch the show, and that's like the number one thing. And like I said in the beginning, that's what makes you hooked into it in the beginning, because they make it, the show purposely made it this way,
right,
to draw everybody in and get their juices flowing about if they were, you know, caught in this zombie apocalypse.
Yeah. Also, little tip. The number one gun for an apocalypse is not a sniper, and it's not an AR. It is a shotgun.
Shotgun.
Why?
Loaded up with buckshot, and you not only have one projectile, but about 20 other projectiles, depending on your gauge. That's a 12 gauge. So you got about 9 projectiles there. 9 to 12, I think. No, maybe not. But anyways, you got 9 going at head height if you aim for the head. It's going to spread. And they go through and penetrate, so you kill more zombies in more time.
Right.
There you go.
I would.
Zombie
I
survival tip 101.
I think yeah, I would. I, you know, whenever I see those scenes of like how, you know, they take on groups of zombies that like a one or two at a time, and they're, and they go at them with little tiny pen knives, because apparently everyone has tiny pocket, they attack them with pocket knives. Mm-hmm. Have you guys noticed that? There are many people in the show
wrists get ripped apart, right?
But everyone has these little tiny knives. Like, I see them and they're like, clink. Yeah, no one has those knives. Carol has that knife. That's even Tara. Perfect, Tara has a little knife. Like, they all these tiny little fucking
literally
knives.
As long as my arm. It's perfect. It's a miniature sword.
Yeah. That's crazy. Yeah, Jesse's 6 feet tall, so he's got a long arm there.
Yeah,
that's
this
crazy.
This is about a foot and a half.
Good God,
2 foot maybe.
Yeah,
but I mean, I would. I think that'd be. I don't know. It's probably scary as fuck. But once you get past that. You know, and learn how to move around these things and stuff.
The show shows us that. That's how the show all began, you know. It was nothing but the zombies, and now it's people, you know.
Yeah. People say, oh, these knives here aren't as effective because they're going to... No, it's going to protect your hand right there. Because if you're going in like that or like that...
That's true.
Then you're going to want something to protect the bottom of your hand. Yeah. So, and you can use that as a melee.
Make some crazy gloves so you
Kevlar like Wolverine gloves or something, man.
There's some Kevlar gloves going on. You got the perfect concoction there.
Yeah.
I think that thoroughly answers her question.
Yeah, I think so too. So why don't we just, I think we're going to end that here. Guys, once again, I think this was a wonderful Q&A. Thank you so much to everybody who wrote in questions and those who didn't get them read on the on this episode. Thank you for writing them in the comments, and we'll get to them in the comments.
And I
just want to really thank everybody for all the support and helping us grow this channel and, you know, enjoying the content we make. And we do have more things coming for you. Right now we're in our off season, we're calling it. We're doing these type of videos. We've got some other things going on that we will be putting up on the channel to, you know, keep
giveaway
everyone.
Giveaway stuff.
What? Q&A you said?
The giveaway.
Giveaways. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, we got some more giveaways coming up.
Maybe we'll announce that within the next week or so.
Yeah, within the next week we're gonna have another video up for that. Plus we still got a couple other I think we want to do our favorite episode videos. We're gonna
do. That's probably
what
we
got
do
humans
next.
And stuff like that happening.
Expect some of that coming up next. Yeah. So, all right. So
keep watching.
Yeah. Again, thank you so much. Anything else, guys? Is anything else we want to mention? I think that's it, right?
I think that's it, yeah.
Yeah. Keep on the lookout for all these other things coming. I hope everyone had a great holiday. I had a wonderful holiday. I hope you guys had a wonderful holiday, Mike and Jess.
Jesse
did. Yeah. We're now in 2017. So, guys, let's make this an awesome 2017. We're starting off great with this awesome video. So, you know, don't forget to like the video and share with people because, you know, we want everyone to get involved with this. And
we enjoy doing these.
Yeah, it's great.
If you couldn't tell.
I love doing this video.
Yeah.
Truthfully, that question was my favorite one.
Absolutely. And great questions. We had amazing questions, and I think it flowed really nicely. So thank you once again, guys. Yeah. And we will definitely see you on the next video. So until then, for third person, my name is Chris.
Mike.
And Jesse.
See, I caught you. I love it. I get you. I got you.
I was waiting on Mike.
You guys didn't know where I was going.
I know. I was looking at his
my
face
hand?
There, wondering what he was going to do.
Yep. Yes. Got him. Anyway, that's it, guys. Thank you so much.
Keep watching.
Gotta wake up earlier to fool me, man.
That's it.
We'll see you on the next video. So thanks, guys. Peace out.
Bye.